I was trying to shake his hand. There's a difference. He doesn't need any help. But we see the move. He's throwing me up. The move of God. And then the recording of, or the assignment and the mission, and then that message that's being shared through that written word. So here we have Brother Mike Dorsey. Come and share us, share with us.
Thank you. First and foremost, I appreciate you for the opportunity to come and share a little bit about my book. And just thank the church family for support and all of that. My book actually launched back in 2015, but I have not done a great job of just stepping up and promoting it. So it's been out there for a while. But one of the things, I know you all are familiar with Maya Angelou. Maya Angelou had a quote that's famous, and it says, when you learn, teach, right? And that kind of plays into Pastor Rascal's message today. You know, when you're blessed with various experiences and, you know, a various journey, what are you going to do with that? And so years ago, through this whole transformational mindset, spiritual growth, and having a family and kids and jobs and losing as many jobs as you gained and all of these different things, you have a journey, right? And so in the midst of that journey, you know, I was inspired to kind of put my life into written word. And the work is called ABE, the acronym ABE, A-B-E, Always Be Engaged, the 7 Keys to Living a Fit Urban Life. And the concept behind ABE are 7 keys that I found deserve my full engagement in life. 7 keys that I found deserve my full engagement in life. And so it's not a prescription for everyone to say, You need to follow these 7 keys to live a great life, but I have defined these 7 keys that they basically, they're 7 keys that I really found really helped me to live a fulfilled life. And the whole concept is to help inspire you to then find areas of your life that deserve your full engagement. And so those 7 keys are, number 1, pray and tithe like a grandparent. See, when you think about faith and when you think about praying and tithing require your action. Right? You must pray yourself. You must actually take action and tithe yourself. So the whole concept of praying and tithing like a grandparent, when you think about grandparents, I haven't seen any faith like the faith of my grandparents. And so when you think about that, that's one area of my life that really deserves my full engagement. Praying and tithing like a grandparent. Number 2 is eat life for life. When you think about what we consume, what we put in our bodies, a majority of what you consume should have been alive at a certain point. Is it packaged? Is it made in a lab or whatever? If the majority of what you consume, you can't pronounce what's on the label and all of that, honestly, that should not be the majority of what you consume. Now, we're all normal, right? Every so often, you know, we consume what we want to consume, that's fine. But the majority of what you consume should have been alive at a certain point. So eat life for life is number 2. Number 3 is train like an athlete. So everybody's heard the term workout, right? Everybody's heard the term workout. If you're wearing gym clothes, walking through the mall, and somebody sees you in your gym clothes, and you tell them, hey, I'm going to work out, they're like, okay, cool, on to the next part of the conversation. If you're wearing that same outfit in the mall, running to your friend, and they ask you what you're about to do, and you say, I'm about to go train, what's the next question out of their mouth? What are you training for? Training is working out with a purpose. Be intentional in how you operate, okay? Number 4 is learn like a scholar. The whole concept of being a continuous learner, reading, having experiences, finding opportunities to learn from everything. Learn like a scholar. Learn like a scholar. Number 5 is embrace travel. You don't necessarily have to travel the world to embrace travel. You can travel in your own city. You can travel in your own neighborhood. Traveling is basically just opening yourself up to experiences that are not common to yourself. Because then you get an opportunity to flip your perceptions on their side and grow. You can't grow if you don't see things that are different. You got to have some detours. You got to embrace detours in life. Number 6 is give continuously and anonymously. See, when we give, a lot of times we give with conditions, right? So if I give and I put my name on it so that you know I give, I'm giving a lot of times because I want to see what your reaction is, right? But if I give continuously and I give anonymously, then I take the power away of making my giving conditional. So therefore, giving continuously and anonymously is important. And number 7 is to find a bit of joy in everything. Because when we look at each situation in life, they're challenging, right? But in every challenge, there's a silver lining. So are you open to being intentional about finding the joy in every situation in life? And if you are, you will find that joy. But if you're not intentional about finding it, guess what? He ain't gonna find it. So for me, the seven keys to living a fit urban life were areas, it basically talks about different scenarios and different situations within my life, but they're also situations that you can kind of look and connect with yourselves. And at the end of the day, it's not about giving you a prescription for life, but it's about you thinking about your own personal life and finding areas that deserve your full engagement. So the book will be available outside. It's $10, and look forward to connecting with you. Thank you.